So in the last class already you have seen about the Archimedes principle and the Bowen principle. Okay, how the Bowen principle is produced when the gravity pulls. Earth has gravitational force when it pulls something towards it, when the ship is there on the surface of the water, and from the downward some force is pushed upwards. That is Bowen force, and that principle is actually Archimedes principle, and that makes the ship to float in the water. So related with that, we'll do some more experiments today based on floating and sinking. Let us see. First, I will take the soap case. Okay? Okay. When I put the soap case in the water, just see, it is floating at the surface of water. Okay. Then there's a soap. When I drop the soap in the water, being heavier, it will go down directly to the bottom of the water. You can see it's going down at the water. But the same soap, if I tip it over the soap case, you can see it is floating. Single soap will sink at the bottom of the water, but this soap, when it is over the soap case, the soap case will not allow it to sink to the bottom. Okay. Now, this is an aluminium foil. Okay, it is an aluminium wrapper of tablets. Now it is in the straight format form. I'll just try to throw in the water. You see, this aluminium foil is floating. Okay. Now I will make it into a bowl shape. I'll try to give it in a bowl shape. I'll just try and see whether it floats or not. Yes, if I fold, when I fold it, this aluminium foil into a bowl shape, still it is floating. Okay, let us do an experiment with this empty bottle. Okay, empty bottle. When I drop this empty bottle in the water with its lid closed, it will float at the surface of the water. Okay, but suppose if I fill that bottle completely with water, okay, this bottle is completely filled with water now, you can see, and I will drop it inside the water. What will happen? It is almost drawn, isn't it? It's almost drawn because it is heavy now. So this is empty bottle which was floating. Then bottle which is filled with water, it has sunk, okay, at the bottom of the water. Now I will take the bottle and fill it half. Fill it to half. Half filled with water now. Now let us see what happen if I'll put it inside the water. So I can say half sunk and half floating. Half part of it is floating. Okay, that's what. Then I'll take this plate. Let us see whether it will float or sink. Oh, it's floating. I'll put some pebbles into it and let's see whether it will float or it will go down. No, it's still floating. One more, I will put the pebble. Still floating. See, still floating. I'll put some more. Still floating. Still floating. And still floating. Okay, so just see. This plate is also floating, and the pebbles which I have put inside the plate. This plate is carrying all the weight and not allowing the pebbles to sink in the water. But if I will drop one pebble into the water, see, it has directly gone to the bottom of the water. It has, just see, directly gone to the bottom of the water. If single pebble or a needle, if I'll drop in the water, it will sink. But if I use a soap case or a plate and over the plate, if I put the pebbles, pebbles will not sink. Isn't it? Nice, no, this one? Okay. So this was about float and sink, and with more things like pencil, then ice cream stick, you can try at home. It's a very nice experiment. You can do it at home. Take a glass with little water. I do not know whether you are able to see. Okay, take a glass with a little water, and I am going to add salt in it. Okay, I'll add the salt. As much as salt that the water will become very much heavy, salty, and will make this egg to float. This, I have put an egg inside this. I have put an egg inside this water, and I have added salt. I have added salt inside this glass of water, and I will see, let us see whether the egg will float or not. It started to float actually. You can see, no, it has started to float. This egg is floating now. Earlier the egg was at the bottom of the water, okay, but when I started adding more and more salt into this water, what happened? The water become much heavier compared to this egg, and that made the egg to float at the surface of water. And the same thing is there, in Dead Sea also. About Dead Sea, I will show you one video and you will come to know more about it. Okay, in Dead Sea also, as the salt content is more in that sea, in that water, it's become so much heavy that you will never draw there. You will float. Okay, even if you are jumping there, you will never go down. You will just float in that water, Dead Sea water. The same thing here also, as I have added more and more salt into this glass of water, that water has become very much heavier, and due to this heaviness, what happened? This allowing the egg to float at the surface of water, because the egg is lighter than the water now. Okay, this experiment which I have shown you, this regarding the salt water and the egg, this one you also have to show me. Clear? Now this is water in a glass, and I will add oil. Any oil you can use, and look at it. See, did the oil mixed with the water? No, I don't think so. Yes, oil is lighter than the water. That is why you can see that yellow colored portion, that is the oil, which yellow colored portion is the oil, that oil is floating at the surface of the water. It did not get mixed up. Okay, that means oil is lighter than water, so it will float at the surface of the water. So oil will never dissolve in water. Oil is insoluble in water. So what is soluble and insoluble? So when I have added salt into this water, after adding salt into the water, see, I won't be able to get the salt again, or I won't be able to separate the salt from this water, because already I have dissolved it. That means what? Salt is soluble in water. And here in this case, oil is floating at the surface of the water. Different layer of oil can be seen. Okay, different layer of water, different layer of oil. That means the oil is insoluble. Salt is soluble in water. Oil is insoluble in water. The substance which can dissolve in water, they are called as soluble. And the substances which are not dissolved in water, they are called as insoluble substances. You can experiment with sugar also. You can use chalk powder, you can use sand, soil, and can do more experiments with soluble and insoluble substances. And after doing the experiments, you can show me in the form of you can just give me the photos or videos and let me know whether you have experimented it or not, what result you have found, that which are soluble, which are insoluble substances. Let me know, okay, after doing the experiments. So I hope it is very much clear to all of you about soluble and insoluble substances and regarding the float and sink of some of the substances. Even if the substance sometimes is heavy, sometimes are heavy, even if the substances sometimes are heavy, they are not sinking at the bottom of the water. Okay, suppose the pebble, when I have poured in the water, it went directly into the bottom of the water. The same pebble, when I just put it over a plate, as the plate is floating, so pebbles also are floating along with. Similar in case of soap also. Okay, and the same is actually the Archimedes principle that makes a ship to float in water.